let's take a look at streaming a video from Backblaze B2. Now, this is the video that I'll be working with. It's a demo that I made for a previous blog post. As you can see, it's about 529 meg, and it's just over 8 minutes of video. Now, I'm going to use FFmpeg to confirm that the metadata for the video is at the beginning of the file. Now, it's an MP4 file, as you can see. And MP4 calls these chunks of the file atoms. So the important thing here is that the move atom, which contains the metadata for the movie, is at the beginning of the file, and that's its offset, 32 bytes into the file, and it's before that MDAT atom, which is the actual data for the movie. As you can see, the move atom is about 356k, and then that MDAT atom is 554 meg. Okay, so that's looking good. The last thing I want to look at here is just taking a look at the file in B2. Now, I uploaded my movie to my MetaDaddy public bucket, and I'm just going to use curl to do a range query. And I'm using head because I just want the headers. I don't want the actual data back. I just want to know how B2 is storing it. So I'll run that. As you can see, I have that 206 HTTP status code. So that's characteristic of the response to a range request. I'm asking for bytes 0 to 9 here, the first 10 bytes. And B2 tells me that it does accept byte ranges, and it would have sent me, if this was a get rather than a head, it would have sent me 0 to 9 bytes of 555 megabytes. And there the content type is video MP4, and the content length is 10. So everything is here for the browser to recognize that this is an MP4 video file, and that B2 can respond to range requests with chunks of the file. Here's my test web page with its embedded video being served from B2. Let's go into Chrome Developer Tools. So we can see it's very simple here. I've got a heading here and then the video control. Now I have to specify the controls attribute. Otherwise I wouldn't get the play button and the volume control here. That's the location of the video. So it's in the same bucket and folder on B2 as the page itself. And I specified a width of 640 pixels just to make the control manageable there on the web page. Now let's look at the network and refresh the page. We can see that Chrome's downloaded the HTML file as we would expect. It's just issued a regular get for that and received the HTML with status code 200. Then Chrome requests the video. Now it actually issues a range request here, but the range is for the entire file, byte 0 onwards. B2 responds with status code 206, and it would send back 555 megabytes of data. But interestingly, Chrome just receives 8.7 megabytes and drops the connection. So what Chrome's doing here is just downloading enough of the video to get that metadata and the first few frames, and then dropping the connection. It's not downloading any more data. Let's mute the video and press play to see what happens next. Now, Chrome has started downloading data. It's issued another range request. So here from about 8 megabytes onwards. And if I go across to timing, we can see that the request isn't finished. So as we watch the video, it's downloading more and more. Now let's see the power of range requests. If I click into the middle of the video, almost immediately, Chrome starts a new download. And if we look at the headers now, it's requested data from 354 megabytes on. So in that last download, it got to about 48 megabytes from the beginning. We clicked into the middle, and now it's downloading from that point on. It's got about 5.5 megabytes, and it's downloading. And we can see that again if we click again a little bit further forwards. We see another range request, skips over all that data, and we are reading from 452 megabytes. Now let's go look at the timing here and see what happens if we pause the video. Now, it takes a few seconds, but I know from previous experience that Chrome will stop downloading data. It'll read ahead for a couple of megabytes, but it won't just keep reading to the end of the file. Because Chrome's able to use progressive download with Backblaze B2, those HTTP range requests, I've been able to skip around and sample this file and only downloaded 64 megabytes of data. Now, with the traditional download, I'd have to wait for all 555 megabytes to arrive before I even started watching. And if I decide after a few seconds that I don't even want to watch that video, I've wasted my time and the service provider's download capacity. Thanks for watching this quick look at streaming video from Backblaze B2.